Hi, my name is Catalin. I'm the owner of POW Gym in Chicago's West Loop. And this is Susan, one of our coaches. We're gonna go through tips for building mitt skills in your boxing classes. One of the first things that you wanna make sure that you integrate into your classes is basic mitt holding skill drills. So the drill's actually as much about the mitt holder as it is about the striker. I think just as we isolate a lead jab or a cross jab or a hook, you should do the same thing on the mitts. And do it with a style of mitt holding that introduces from the very beginning feeding mitts as opposed to a static mitt holding position. That way students start understanding how to create the proper placement of the mitt for the striker. In creating the proper placement for the striker, you're also going to reduce the amount of injuries that the mitt holder will incur over the course of months of training and the typical mistakes that they might make. So have all your mitt holders begin with their right mitt on their chest so that they're only gonna feed their lead jab and the lead mitt. And you would count it out in a team drill. Your cue to them would be right hand on your chest, left hand is gonna work, and every time the mitt comes up, you are gonna take the label of the mitt or the center point of the mitt and point it at your partner's nose, lining up their jab. And then you are gonna bring it back. And then you're gonna bring it out. And you're gonna bring it back. And you're gonna bring it out. So then you would count that out as a coach in your class and then roll it into maybe a 2-minute round. So it would look like this. Guards up. Mitt on your chest, left hand feeds the lead jab. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And that would be where I would begin in building basic mitt holding skills that uses more of a feeding style of mitts than a static holding position. So we have a couple things that we want students to develop, in my opinion, very early on as a boxing student, new, as a beginner even. Good mitt holding skills and how to include footwork or basic footwork movement. So building off the first lesson that we just went through, we can now add a cone. The cone represents kind of that midline. And the goal is that we both kind of maintain our own space behind the cone. So I don't kind of smother her, and she doesn't come in and smother me. Because that's the other thing you see with new pad holders is the mitts are so close that punches don't really have the opportunity, particularly jabs, to develop that nice long extension. So they kind of work out, and this helps to create a visual as well as understand how to distance yourself from your target. Now we have basic footwork. So you would just have them change directions about every 180 degrees so that they also don't get dizzy. Feeding the mitt the exact same way, but I would do this perhaps as an interval or a 2-minute round. Then 180, we go back the other way, so now they learn how to move towards their right side. Same as this. Same as for the lefties. So that would be a beginner, but in a round that has a multiple skills, you could just have them double the jab, triple the jab. So the progression is already there. But notice as a pad holder, I'm still practicing the feed no matter what, and then you would continue to move back and forth. So once again, we need drills that build skills for the striker and the mitt holder that can easily be progressed in a class of beginners and more advanced students. Give that a try.